with deportation.
Up with liberation.
Down, down with deportation.
Down,
down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation. Down, down with deportation.
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 Deportation. Deportation.
Deportation.
Deportation. Deportation. Deportation.
I work for the largest liberal organization in the country, the AFL-CIO. Not only I work there, I'm one of the leaders. I'm the executive vice president.
Yes.
Just keep in mind, I also happen to be an immigrant. I also happen to be a refugee. For anybody who wants to know what a refugee looks like, this is what a refugee looks like. I get up in the morning and I work for people like you. I am not a terrorist. I am not a danger for this country. I have helped build this country.
Yes.
And
yes.
All of us have to admit that. So I don't know how many of you watched or were at the hate conventions that was going on in Cleveland. Speaker after speaker start getting up and saying, my mother was an immigrant, my father was an immigrant. At the same breath, the next minute, they proposed deporting 12 million hardworking Americans. That is not acceptable in this country.
No.
But it is not only about the other party. We want the Democratic Party to have the backbone to say enough is enough.
Yes, yes.
Fight for them, to fight for them. We need to hear them loud and clear that they value every family in this country.
Yes. Yes.
In this country. So I appreciate you. We march. We fight. We march. At the end of the day, we have to protect our own families. And they have to hear us. And you have to be loud enough. We have to be loud enough that they hear us. Enough is enough. Thank you so much for standing up and fighting for your families, for my family, for everybody's family. Thank you.
Yes.
Councilwoman Helen Gibb, give her a round of applause.
Yay!
All right, Hotas and everybody here, thank you so much for being out here today. My name's Helen Gibb, I'm the new councilwoman here in Philadelphia, but I came out of the immigrant rights struggle here in this city. Together, we fought to make our voices visible and heard. Together, we've worked to reclaim our public schools and to create spaces and to demand a voice around mass incarceration, an end to deportation, and
yes.
The school-to-prison pipeline.
Yes! Yes!
I want to also talk about that thanks to the hard work of this community, that this is going to be a diverse fight all the way to the home.
crowd, an amazing young leader from Juntos. Some of you may remember him from a couple of weeks ago where he was part of a civil disobedience where he blocked the entrance to I-76 here, demanding a stop to the deportations that are affecting our community. He is an amazing young person. He is only 13 years old in middle school right now. He is shown so much right now to be an amazing young leader in our community and for our movement right now. I want to bring up to the megaphone right now, Eddie Pettis.
Woo!
And as a young person in Philly, our schools are underfunded and over-policed. This feels like an unsafe place to even live in because of the assaults or other problems at school. For example, there was an incident about a student who tried going to the bathroom and he didn't have his key card. In frustration, he threw an orange at the wall and the school police officer punched him and put him in chokehold because of that. This is an abuse of authority. I feel so much safe in my community, but as Latinos and immigrants in Philly, including my parents and friends, we don't always feel safe because of the racism and abuse of power that we see in cops.
Yes. Yes.
Who knows what will happen with all the racist people we see, but I see racism when people say Latinos steal people's jobs or that we don't have papers or racist people cause us illegals. In my community, I see criminalization when the police target Latinos and immigrants for small issues, and sometimes even call immigration and put us in detention, and our families face deportations. When I was little, my father and cousin were robbed at gunpoint, but my father and my cousin were scared to call the police because of immigration. It seemed that police was working with immigration. The fear my family and community feels because of the police and racism has to stop. We have to stop police abuse, stop police damaging citizens, and stop police killing black and brown people.
Woo!
A few weeks ago, I was arrested because we Latinos and immigrants are fighting for DAPA. We demand for Obama to stop deportations and for
yes.
the district to spend their money on education and not
yes.
on more security.
Yes, yes.
Obama made many promises, broke them, or didn't accomplish them. So we say, Hillary, no more promises. We demand action now.
Go, Eric! Go, Randall! Come
on! Community, and just so happens to be Eric's mama, his mother, ma. So, un aplauso para María Hernández.
Desde muchos lugares para estar aquí. Estamos en la misma lucha y ya estamos aquí porque estamos cansados ya de tantas promesas que si cruzamos fronteras y estamos aquí, estamos para luchar y vamos a seguir luchando por el respeto. No queremos más deportaciones. Estamos exigiendo que ya no estén dando más promesas, que no nos arrebaten de nuestros hijos, que no nos arrebaten de nuestros padres. Es injusto todo lo que nos están dando en la educación de nuestros hijos. Nos los están quitando al deportarnos como padres, a quitarnos de nuestros hijos. Nos están quitando también la educación hacia ellos, porque no sabemos en dónde los van a mandar. Estamos cansados ya de todo y yo creo que estamos aquí para exigir. No estamos pidiendo, estamos exigiendo que desmantelen ICE. No más deportaciones. Es injusto que nuestras familias estén detenidas en centros de detenciones. ¿Por qué tienen que estar allá? ¿Solo por buscar una vida mejor para sus hijos? Como nosotros, necesitamos libertad. Eso es lo que queremos y es lo que estamos exigiendo. Vamos con esa fuerza, esa energía para luchar. Que no más promesas. Si están allá arriba, todos esos políticos que están allá, están sentados por nosotros, por todos nosotros que estamos pagando su sueldo de ellos, que nomás están haciéndose tontos allá y nomás nos están hablando. Estamos ya cansados de que estén mantenidos por nosotros. Nos discriminan, nos hacen lo que quieren y aún así están comiendo de nosotros. Vamos a seguir luchando, no más promesas, que suelten que liberen a nuestras familias, que las suelten de las detenciones, que ya las cierren. Es injusto todo lo que nos están dando. Queremos
luchan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Más fuerte, nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras.
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard, it's going hard. It's being concrete that we walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge. And I was built for this. I think that we all have a purpose in life. And mine's going to take on a task that most of us that most of back away from. Impossible. Some people say it's impossible. I see possibility. I don't see anything as being impossible. Mentalities, there are different ways to teach people how to read. There's different ways to communicate people. So I do see hope, and I see hope in us all coming together and understanding each other and learning to respect.
Pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor por el pueblo no reconoce sus fronteras. Nos deportan cada día, pero somos de la tierra. Mi amor.